Oh, this is the Palm Motel here in Santa Monica on 14th Street, just at the corner of Pico Boulevard, which is named after the first governor, or the last Mexican governor of California. And right next door, petrol station, in which you can get a cup of coffee in the morning. I think we could certainly put up with having one of these. Okay, this is Friday morning. We're gonna head up to Los Angeles City itself. Maybe go to the tar pits.
That thing.
It's like a cobra.
It's a thunderbird of some kind.
In a quarter of a mile, turn right onto the I-10 East Slip Road.
What's off or something, I don't know.
Have you?
In a quarter of a mile, turn left onto South Fairfax Avenue. Continue on South Fairfax Avenue for 1 mile.
Hair. Check out advancedhair.com. Once again, it's 8499. Hair and food delivery services may be in violation of
the lights and the stop sign.
Look, this is like my old Oldsmobile.
It's 800-900-0000 in Sweet James.
What was that?
Where am I going up here?
The second traffic light you pass, and then the next block will be a stop sign, and the stop sign you take a right
turn. Quality candidate within the first day. Now try ZipRecruiter free at ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Take the next right onto West Pico Boulevard.
So really, we could have come right up Pico Boulevard.
She has two daughters.
In a quarter of a mile, turn left onto South Kirsten Avenue. Take the next left onto South Kirsten Avenue.
Subaru is one of the largest Subaru dealers in the area, and that means more selection for you. With inventories rising, Timmons Subaru is now offering discount rates.
And the Mexicans are the gardeners.
Oh, yeah. Getting a lot of grass blown off the pass.
We're going 0.7 miles straight on. That's very Singaporean, isn't it? That kind of green on top.
It's very LA as well, too.
Try to put some Spanish style into these houses.
Remember, what was that film where a volcano erupted, or the tar pits erupted?
No, it was Ice Age, wasn't it?
No.
It's a movie. It was Pierce
Brosnan. They were stopping the lava going down the street.
Yeah, it was something like a volcano event. So go down to the bottom and take left.
Turn left, then your destination will be on the left.
Oh, here.
Yeah. No parking here. What's the solution?
Parking just down that street there.
All right.
Okay, we got to Los Angeles City. We're gonna go and have a look at these tar pits. It's a museum up there where they've got the discoveries from the tar pits. Just in case you were in any doubt what tar is like, there's a real smell of tar here as well. It's a This lake's actually left over from asphalt mining operations in the 1800s, but it's still fed from a deep underground oil field, which is why it bubbles and stuff over in the middle.
I'm thinking that it might not be from current activity, it might be just artificial.
Most people over there said, "What the hell is that?"
No, they didn't say a thing, did they?
Right, so this is the museum just next door to the lake there, but we're not going in there. We've got to do some other stuff instead. What is it? A Smilodon fatalis. There's some prehistoric giant sloths. There are smaller tar pits and fossil digs around the park here as well. These ones aren't so big as or spectacular as the main lake, but they're still there.
They find the tip of a bone.
And they have to fence them off because it's tarry inside. Now they have a theatre there, they can do presentations and stuff. Another pit over there. Observation pit it says here, and that's the Museum of Art behind it. Go over and see these street lights over here, I guess. Now this is the Museum of Art over here, and I think that's the Automotive Museum over there. Here are all the main LA streets in this window display here.